Hi guys, it's Shauna, and today's April 28th, and it is a Tuesday, and it is around 7:30 at night, and I am in my room again recording this, and so I thought I would just get on here really quick and explain some of the things that I'm going through right now with regards to COVID. So I can honestly say that I have not really been affected by this other than me getting sent home from school and me having to live at home. And that is going on with millions of college kids, millions of people around the world. So this is actually the first time that it's actually affected something in my life, like really, really affected. That's things that have to change a lot, and it keeps having to change. So I'm in the education program at Iowa State, like I've said before, and there is a test, it's called the Praxis, that you have to take before you get into your it's called blocks before you get into your methods courses, and it's called blocks. And so we have to take a class before I can get into my first set of blocks. I have to pass the Praxis before I can get into my first set of blocks. And I'm not gonna lie, I've had some struggles passing it, and I shouldn't, but I've had. And so if I didn't have problems, this would have never been a problem. But since I have, I was set to take the Praxis. I passed the reading, and I still have to pass reading. I still have to pass writing and math. And so I was set to take my math April 18th. And then I was set to take my writing May 15th, I want to say it was. And so, as we all know, April 15th, that got canceled because that was at the beginning of everything really going on. And it wasn't happening. Our state got, not put on shutdown, but basically everything closed. And then actually, no, the Prometric, that's okay. Ugh. Okay, so I'm taking my test at a center called Prometric, and they have closed down all of their testing centers around the world, the USA and Canada, and I think some other places. And so they've closed down their centers to take the test. And so the first time they closed it down till April 30th, and I was like, okay, I can sign up to take it again, me being optimistic, thinking that this was just going to clear up. No, I signed up to take it on... So I said I was supposed to take it April 18th, and then I was supposed to take it May 15th. It is not May yet. Ugh, these days. And I was supposed to take it May 15th. I hope this is all making sense. I was supposed to take it May 15th, and then last night I get on the little website to see if there have been any changes, because yesterday the governor announced that I think 77 counties can open up things and 22 cannot. I think it's like that. And one of them, of course, and one of them being is Marshalltown. That's where I'm from. And it's not, our cases are rising each day. And I'll get into that in a second. But so she said 77 counties can open, 22 cannot. And Des Moines, that's where I'm supposed to take my test. It's Polk County. It's the capital. Many people there populated. And so with that being that, they did not open again. And so I was just thinking it was just in Iowa. No, I get online and it said that the Prometric has decided to close all of their testing facilities till May 30th. When I saw that, I was like, are you serious? I went into my mom and dad's room and I was like, I'm gonna cry. Cause I was just like, I'm ready for it to be done. Since I've been having problems with this for a while. And now that I know I can pass it, I've been studying my butt off. I've been doing all I can possible. And after I've done so much work to get this done. And when I know I can do it, I can't. And so, that's how I feel about that. And so I don't know when I'm gonna take it. I don't know how I'm gonna take it. I don't know where I'm gonna take it. They're supposed to be sending us an email out sometime when, and saying that we can reschedule. So I'm just praying. I just hope it all works out. I can honestly say this is the first time that it's actually affected me in some way. With school it did, but that affected a lot of people. And we all got sent home. We all got school online. But this, I'm just like, and I hate to complain because there are people out there that are doing so much, that have so much more going on, and then I sit back and think of how selfish I am, but that's a different story for a different day. All right, so what was I gonna say I was gonna explain? Oh, my state. Like I said, I'm from Iowa. I don't know if your mom's wife is watching this, but like I said, I'm from Iowa, and our governor has not done an in-at-home, a stay-at-home shelter-in-place thing. And the results are kind of showing just a little bit, day by day. I wish I had my computer. It's in the living room. But I wish I had my computer so I can read off how many new cases are a day, how many deaths are a day. Today is the very first time I've actually... A lady my mom worked with, they're really, really good friends. And a few weeks ago, like before this all happened, my mom saw the lady at Walmart and she was like, if my mom gets this, she's not gonna make it. And then my mom gets a text today and saying that her mom passed away last night because of COVID. And I just sit back and think like, oh. And then something else that just scares me, oh my goodness. So my granny, she is 86 years old. And she is in a nursing home, and I'm here in Marshalltown. And one of the workers there it was a night worker, that's all we know. It was a night worker that got tested positive for coronavirus. And I'm just like, oh, so many questions. There's so many what ifs, like what's gonna happen next? And then another thing that is just terrifying me is that we keep getting these updates on our phone that, yeah, oh, it's gonna flatline over summer, but once October, November comes around, what's gonna happen? Like, that's when school starts, and there's just so many questions. Like, are we gonna have to do school online? Because I honestly really don't think I can do another semester online. This is hard. I give props to the people that do things online. And I say, I know I want to do grad school online, but that's different. You know you want to do that. I want to be able to be in the classroom. I want to be able to have hands-on learning, and it's so different. Like, and emailing stuff, and then Zooms are great, but you don't get all the information across. You don't get everything across. I feel like all my videos are just tangents, but I keep asking myself, what's gonna happen next? And that's the thing, is like, I know I say this in every video, it's like a broken record. We don't know what's gonna happen next. We don't know what's gonna happen in a few months. We don't know what's gonna happen tomorrow, next week. And like, I don't know if I said this before, but I work at a summer camp, and I get emotional. If I cannot work with my camp kids, and I call them my kids because we spend, how many months of summer? May, June, July, August. We spend 3 months together from sometimes 7 a.m. to 5 a.m. every single day. They become, I'm gonna miss them if I can't have camp. And that's, another thing that's so selfish of me is just to say is that, I want camp. But I have to, there's so much that I could talk about and that I want to, every time I pull out the camera, the things that I want to say pop in my head, and that's why it's like poof this, poof that, poof, poof, poof. Different topics each time, and I'm like, but I don't know. It's dead week. I think I've said that before. It's dead week, so next week is finals, and I think I've said this before. Getting like a to-do, I don't know if you can see it. Getting like a to-do list, that's kind of like a bad to-do list. But this is, getting a to-do list and writing things down that you need to do, that's really, really helped me with different things and getting things done and making sure that I'm doing them correctly and writing emails, sending emails to your teachers, asking questions. My professors probably are tired of me. I said, there's this one class. And I was like, I don't know if I'm doing this right. And I was like, in my mind, I know I'm doing it right, but I just want to check that I'm doing it right. And so, and then with school going online, a lot of teachers are not doing tests anymore. We're gonna do projects. And so I have to write a lesson plan and I have to teach a lesson plan. It's just, these last couple weeks have been, So, yes.